Hello, and welcome to Kingdom One Live, where it's all about a kingdom perspective. I'm your host, Deborah Asbury. Today's program comes to you in part by JVC, Party Rentals, and Event Hall, where the best parties start here. It's located in Lilburn, Georgia. Also by AE Fitness of Loganville, Georgia. Owner-operator Alan Elliott. Get motivated, remain inspired, crush complacency. Today's guest is a modern-day prophet. She comes bringing a clear understanding of what a prophet is in today's society, whether you're in the church or in the world. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Georgia Peach, who is an incredibly early age, found that she was gifted with the prophetic anointing, which made her the third generation of prophets in her family. She is the founder of Fountains of Blessings Ministry and Daughters of Legacy. In addition, she is a subject matter expert and associate producer of the Prophetic Voice segment of Kingdom One Live, which we are starting today. She is also a mother and just a dear friend of mine. Please welcome to Kingdom One Live, Lydia Shumake. Welcome, Lydia.
Welcome. Thank you so much, Deborah.
Girl, I am just so excited to have you here, and I'm really excited to have you as my subject matter expert because of the fact, you know, we've known one another. Gosh, we go back, I want to say about 7 years now.
Correct.
I met you initially through a mutual friend, so we have to give Sherry Graham a shout out, of course.
Yes. Thank you, Sherry.
Yes, for, you know, allowing us to be able to meet. And throughout that time, you and I have gotten to know one another through the Women of Prominence, mm-hmm. which is a Wednesday Bible study.
Yes.
And you have taught on a number of occasions. And what I noticed is during the teaching, God has just gifted you so much. You're so encouraging with that gift. It's been, I don't know, just a number of times where the ladies would reach out to me later and they would say, the lady, I don't remember her name right now. She said blah, 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 and it happened just as she said it. So Lydia, talk with us about, you know, when did you first realize that you were gifted with, you know, that sense of, they call it in the world sixth sense, but we know in the kingdom of heaven, yes. that is a prophetic gift. And so talk with us about.
Well, Deborah, I give God all the praise, honor, and glory.
Amen.
For that.
Yes.
Because
yes,
I don't take it lightly, but I'm so honored to have it.
Yes.
I remember at the age, it was between 8 and 9 years old. Mm-hmm. And I was sitting in my bedroom one day, and I just kept hearing this voice speak to me. And of course, I thought it was my parents calling my name.
Oh, really?
So after numerous trips down the hall to the kitchen, when I came back the last time, my father said, go back in your room, Lydia, and say, yes, Lord. And when I sat there and said that, it was just, I heard this voice so clearly, so distinctly. That
wow.
I was just excited, and I knew that there was something special taking place in my life.
Oh, my God. So it was just like having a prophet. You remember Prophet Samuel?
Mm-hmm.
Whenever
mm-hmm.
he was at the temple and his mother had taken him to the temple
right.
to be raised by Eli, who mm-hmm. was the priest.
That's correct.
And then in the middle of the night, I think it went, he went to Eli and he said, that you called me?
Mm, that's right.
And so your story happened that same way.
It surely did. And the ironic thing about it, my grandmother, which is my father's mother,
right.
she operated in the prophetic. And she was quite, quite accurate.
Okay.
If she had lived today, they would have called her Catherine Comer.
Oh,
and
wow.
my father was very accurate too. So
I was,
yes, I was because they started mentoring me at a young age.
Wow, praise God. Mm-hmm. That's so amazing. Everyone doesn't have that gift.
No, they don't.
And many desire to have it. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, you know, some they think they have it and they miss.
That's right.
But I'll have to say, as far as close acquaintances and close friends, maybe two more have been pretty much spot on in different predictions and prophecies that you have made.
That's right.
So in today's time, we know the fivefold ministry talks about, you know, the prophet mm-hmm. being one of those offices within the fivefold. That is a key office. But talk of us about, you know, the gift of prophecy, the fivefold ministry, and where you see it within the church and the world in today's society.
Okay. The fivefold ministry is necessary. However, when you read the Bible, it mm-hmm. says to, you want the best gift to, you know, pray for the one that is most desirable, and that is the gift of the prophet. And that's what I did. I started praying that God would just expound on that gift that I had.
Right.
But it takes a lot of spending time
yes.
within the presence of God.
Absolutely.
The church actually needs that more now than ever before, because we're living in a world now where there's so much taking place.
Yes.
And so much deceitfulness is out here.
It really is.
So what God is doing now is He's bringing those prophets that have been hidden that's
yes.
on the backside. He's bringing them to the forefront right now.
To the forefront.
Because,
and I agree.
Mm-hmm,
I agree.
Mm-hmm.
I do feel that the church needs to embrace that gifting.
They need
that
to.
Office of the fivefold gifting more so now than ever before.
Absolutely.
With so much going on
mm-hmm.
in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And the Bible also says that nothing takes place unless it's spoken through a prophet,
that's
right?
That's right. He sure does. He tells us that. And see, what is going on now, people want the microwave situation. But when you become a prophet, it takes time. It takes that intimate relationship
absolutely.
With the Lord. With God said that He will not allow His people to be ignorant of the enemy devices.
Right, right.
That's the reason why we've got to embrace the prophets that are
absolutely.
Spending time. And there are some that are false prophets out here.
Right.
But the ones that are true false prophets,
right,
you
right.
can test the word.
And you know what? And I'm glad you mentioned that too, because when you talk about spending time with God in our girlfriend friendship circle, you do share with us many times how the Lord has woken you up at mm-hmm. 3 a.m. and you got up from 3 to 6, then you took a nap because He was speaking to you and you were writing notes.
That's right.
And then you prayed, and I'm like, wow. You know, you have really got to be disciplined.
You do.
And you've really got to be committed and know that you know.
That's right.
That this is your calling that God has upon your life, and you're so faithful to it. I just pray and hope that as prophets come to the surface and start taking their rightful place in the church, that they will be just like you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank
so
you.
One other thing, when you think about people with gifting to read tarot cards, and they're reading palm reading and spiritualists, and you see these signs and hands, and they want people to come and they pay to hear their fortune. Talk with us about the difference between that gifting versus the gift of prophecy that the Bible talks about. Well, the Bible talks about both of them, of course,
mm-hmm.
but the one that's part of the fivefold ministry within the church and the body of Christ.
Okay. When we look at the area of a prophet, that is a gift from God.
Yes.
Which we receive the unction of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And that gives us this word from the Lord. When we go into those other channels, the tarot cards and things of that nature.
Yes.
God tells us to stray away from that because it defiles us. And what happens, it leads people down a road to destruction. And that dark road to destruction always ends up being a representative of the enemy.
Wow. So you know what? That's enough of an explanation to me. Mm. And I hope to our audience, too, to really shy away from that. Everyone wants to know the future. We want to know if we're going to get married, if we're going to get a certain job, if we're going to, you know, be voted into a particular office. There's so many things that we are wanting to know about our future. But we do have to trust God and walk by faith and not by sight. And definitely stay away from anything that takes us down that dark road into the hands of the enemy. Because he never plays fair.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't.
So we're going to go ahead and get prepared for break right now. And when we get back, we're going to shift gears a little bit and do something just a little more lighthearted than this conversation. But it's so exciting and definitely informative. So stay with us. We'll be right back with more of Kingdom One Life, where it's all about a kingdom perspective.
At Faith Shakers Collection, faith is not confined to Sundays. We're shaking up the scene with threads that shout beliefs loud and proud. From everyday casuals to Sunday best, the Faith Shakers Collection's purpose is for people to find the perfect fit that reflects their inner fire. Faith Shakers Collection, reflecting faith through wardrobe. We are on Instagram at Faith Shakers Collection.
And welcome back to Kingdom One Live, where it's all about a kingdom perspective. I've been here talking with my special guest, who is also part of the family here at Kingdom One Live, Lydia Shumake. She is the subject matter expert and associate producer of the Prophetic Voice segment of Kingdom One Live here this season, season 3. So, Lydia, before our break, you had shared with us pretty much the fact that the gift of prophecy and the office of a prophet is needed more in the church now, more now than ever before, in the church as well as the world. Mm-hmm. And so when we think about the different prophets of old, the prophets in the Old Testament, of course, is there a particular prophet that you identify more with?
Yes. And as a matter of fact, it is your namesake, Deborah.
Oh, well, you know what? That's funny you said that, because I identify with her as well. Wow. Why?
I love Deborah so much because Deborah was not only a prophetess. She was a judge. She was a wife.
Yes.
And I'm sure she had other roles that she probably played in the Bible.
Right.
However, she had such a close relationship with the Father that when he gave her instructions to tell Barak to take over the army of Syria and to destroy them, she did not hesitate.
Right, right. She just had that assurance.
She had that assurance that she knew that she knew that she knew that she was backed by him.
Amen. And that God would protect her.
That's
and
right.
She would be okay. I love her too because of the fact that she is just so balanced. And you are a balanced woman as well, professionally, as well as with your gifting of being a prophet.
Thank you. Thank you.
Lydia, what do you hear the Lord speaking to you about now, whether it's in the church or whether it's in the secular world? Talk with us for a moment.
Well, Deborah, as a matter of fact, I was looking at a young lady in the audience.
Okay.
And the Holy Spirit just started burning within my spirit. There was a burning in my spirit, and I know I had a word for her.
Okay.
She's in the green. That's
Natalia.
Natalia.
Okay. Let's have Natalia. We can have her come on up.
Please.
And she's with her grandmother.
Yes, I need both of them to come.
Ladies, come on up. Let's give it up for Natalia and her grandmother, Cynthia, is my dear friend. Come on up and be seated, ladies. Praise God.
Natalia, when I first laid eyes on you, I heard the Lord say there was an explosion that He's about to do in your life. Things are about to explode in your life like never before. God has gifted you with the seer's anointing. There are things that you see in the spiritual realm and dreams that you've had, but it's nothing compared to where God is about to take you.
Amen.
God said the favor of God is all over your life. You're getting ready to walk in the doors that you never dreamed of. You're going to sit in places that you said, how in the world did I get here? But one of the key things that God wants you to always do is to give Him the praise, honor, and glory.
Hallelujah.
The more you praise Him, the more you spend time with Him,
yes,
the higher God is going to take you.
Yes.
And God said that I can literally trust you with my money. God
Amen.
Said you have instilled a lot within this granddaughter. He said, but you've instilled a lot in both of your granddaughters, and you've spent a lot of time praying because you put placed seeds in them.
Amen.
And the Lord said that He is going to bless you with a long life. There's a scripture that said, with long life shall I satisfy thee,
yes,
and assure Him of our salvation.
Amen.
God said, there's nothing you're going to want to wait, want to even desire that you're going to have to wait on. All you need to do is just ask.
Amen.
There are some things you're asking for right now, but you're in a place of that hesitation. And God said,
Amen.
Just believe.
Amen. Praise God. And you know what, Lydia, what you may not know is Cynthia is my dear friend. And everything that you just shared, you didn't know. God's had His hands upon Natalia's life all of her life. Cynthia's always called and telling me, Natalia's the homecoming queen. Natalia is the class president. Natalia, and she, at 2 years old, she was a prodigy. She did the books of the Bible. At 2 years old, she could get up in front of the church and speak them all.
Oh my God.
But you know what? We're going to have more of Kingdom One Live when we return. We're going to have to go to break right now, but I am just so excited and full to see what the prophetic voice confirms and encourages today here on Kingdom One Life. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
Nice.
Amen. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Kingdom One Live. I'm just so full right now because I'm here with the prophetic voice segment. This is a new segment for season 3, and I'm here with my subject matter expert, associate producer, Lydia Shumake, who also has friends of mine who were in the audience come up, and she just shared a powerful word with them. So, Lydia, I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to you to finish sharing with Cynthia Dunlap, as well as Natalia House.
Okay. Cynthia, one of the things that I heard the Lord say was that He's going to be healing your body because there's healing in this place. He said, all I need you to do is just trust me. And there is some debt that you have been praying about. Mm-hmm. God said he's getting ready to cancel those debts.
Thank you. Amen.
And I just, and God's grace and favor is all over you. I just feel it.
Praise God.
And well, there have been some things that have been stagnated. They will no longer be stagnated any longer.
Let's just go ahead and praise the Lord for that right now. I am just in agreement. Praise the Lord. Okay, so we're going to get ready for our musical guest today, who is no stranger to Kingdom One Live. She was with us last season, and she's back this season. She has a new musical project entitled Beautifully Broken, Victoriously Healed. She currently is the Minister of Music at New Life Community Center, and she is going to perform for us today a song entitled Atmosphere, which was written by her. Let's hear it for Nicole, Denae.
Come.
In closing today, I would like to say thank you to our special guest, Prophetess Lydia Shumake. She is part of the team here. Also, to our phenomenal musical guest, Nicole, Denae. Can we all prophesy is the question I pose. In 1 Corinthians 14:31, the Apostle Paul says, "For you can all prophesy in turn so that everyone may be instructed and encouraged." This tells me that prophecy can be used as a form of encouragement. So therefore, we should all be encouragers. Remember, if no one else encourages you, be sure to encourage yourself in the Lord. So what are your thoughts? Feel free to weigh in on our discussions. Like us, subscribe to the YouTube channel as well as the Facebook page. And join us here weekly on Kingdom One Live, where it's all about a kingdom perspective. Until next time, love and blessings.